All right, so we're back with another video today. We just got back from the RunningLane Championships out in Huntsville, Alabama. It went well for the most part. We've got a good race video coming for you today, and we also got interviews with some exclusive runners, so stay tuned for that. It's going to be good. And yeah, if you like the content, like and subscribe. It only gets better from here. So yeah, go and hop right into it.
See you, Sam.
In Vegas, yeah, I drink Jaeger. Four bangers get serenaded by ladies basically naked. It's crazy, this life I take it, yeah. Everybody notice. White girls drink vodka sodas. Jack and Coke to get you open. Tequila shots are the dopest, and I love it. The way you look so fine when I'm faded on my tension and tonic. But keep on getting persuaded that I want it. Crack a chain and stay. Invite all your lady friends. Tell them all your tales. She whiskey like a cowboy. Both guns go off to be wild boys. Got a light skinned girl, sip tall boys. Jump around, get loud, makes mad noise. Gun out, he likes like a college kid. So many girls come and grab one bitch. Toast to the boss, toast to the bras. Ha, no wonder
mom, Justin! Justin, let's go! Let's go!
Alright, so how'd you feel today? What was the race plan?
It felt good. You know, I felt light on my feet the whole race. I knew I had it in the bag the entire time. Yeah, I hit hill hard and just kept it all the way, you know?
Yeah, where was the move made? Yeah, Kamari up front, rolling.
Oh yeah, back hill, hit it hard. I knew I had it when I got to the top of it, so.
Oh yeah, good work, good work. How was the, where'd you come to the mile at? How are you feeling?
I came through at 410. Really just hauling ass out there, you know?
Oh yeah.
Second mile was like a 355, so a little slow, but you know, we picked it up at the end.
355?
Yeah, 355, yeah, that's the goal.
All right, so how are you gonna celebrate the win? It's been a long year, long grind.
Definitely throw some back with the boys, you know? Get some birds out there, you know? We'll see.
Oh, I feel, all right, have a good night.
Yeah.
Sir, I'll see you. Specialist, how you feeling today? What are the thoughts?
Today was a fun race and I had a great time and I ran very good.
Good. So how'd it feel at the 1 mile mark rolling with them?
At the 1 mile mark I felt super relaxed. I didn't expect to really feel so smooth out there. So I had a good time. And I just wanted to kind of go out there and send it for the boys one more time.
Yeah, I feel. How'd it feel, Parker's move at the 2 mile mark, getting dropped? How'd it feel?
Well, see, the thing is that I told Parker to make the move, so he wouldn't have done it if it weren't for me. So basically, in a way, I think I am the national champion today. And so when he made that move, I was just like, yeah, he's pretty good. And so I just figured that, you know, I would let him win this one. And so I slowed off just to make sure.
Oh yeah, I understand it. I understand it. I'd sign with that. All right, so the race is over, season's over. Senior season, how are you gonna celebrate tonight? What's the move?
The senior season is over, so the boys are getting together. We're gonna have a little quarantine party, have a nice little time with the guys, and celebrate the end of the year.
All right, let's see it. Have a good one.
Thank you.
All right, so I hope you enjoyed those interviews and the little race video for whatever it was. I don't really know how it turned out at the moment, but yeah, hope it was good. So I'm gonna go and hop into like my race breakdown from my point of view and just like my thoughts about it as a whole, because it was a pretty good big race, like super deep field, it was super stacked. So yeah, we got out with it being just a championship race, like such a deep field. The first 400 was smoking. I heard like 58, 59, which I think that is a little over the top, but it was obviously quick. Our first 800 was around like 211 at the front. And yeah, I mean, it was kind of like, as a lot of us kind of expected, like Kamari really set the tone early and was hammering and really forced all of us to just like get on it, hop on the pain train and go with them. And we came to the mile like 4:33. Kamari was like 4:30 flat, maybe, I don't know. But yeah, my watch clicked off at like 4:29. I looked down and I was like, holy crap, we were flying. But it was also like net downhill, so it was really fast, but it was manageable at the same time. And for like my own race, I was not really feeling the best at the moment. That felt really fast to me. But I knew like all I did was just run my race, keep myself positioned, and just like stay in the moment and just stay there. Stay where I needed to be at. I mean, coming after the mile mark, you have to be like lead back up towards like the center of the place. And it's kind of just a long grind, like incline back up to the center area. And at that point, we just were a big pack. Kamari was up front with maybe a 10, 15 meter lead on us, like still just hammering the pace. And we were all just kind of balled up on each other, just trying to keep the gap reasonable, but also just stay steady. And like we were kind of feeding off each other at the same time. By the time we reached the top, and we were like shifting places and stuff, Parker and Sully stayed up front. We were like running really strong pretty much the whole way. Then we got up there, and then we took the bend back around, aiming back towards the 2 mile mark. And at that point, I was slowly kind of like drifting back towards the front of the pack. But at the same time, like Sully and Parker, Parker was really starting to like push himself away from like the rest of the pack. And we were stringing out in that little group that was a big blob at first, approaching the 2 mile mark at that point. And I was just in the middle of that little strung out group, but I was still tagging on a pretty good bit. And then, so we click off the 2 mile mark. I think Soli told me he came through at about 9:19. So it was quick for the 2 mile mark. I had like 4:50 on my watch about for the 2 mile split. So yeah, I was still quick through the 2 mile mark. It was obviously all uphill, so it was a bit slower. After we kind of came to the 2 mile mark, it was back downhill. You do like a downhill and then you do like a 200 meter like climb back up to the whole like top half of the course. So that hill hit pretty hard. And at that point, the race was kind of stringing out. Parker was starting to try to close the gap on Kamari. Kamari was running like awesome race. He was just still crushing it up at front, like forcing like all of us to just like string out and like really making the race turn into a real hard race. But yeah, like at that point, I was kind of still in the mix in the pack. I was probably still shifting around, but at the bottom of the hill, I was probably in about like 10th or so place. And I can't, to be honest, for my part, I ran pretty weak up the hill, I would say. Not near as strong as I wanted to. And I was probably back to like anywhere from like 12th to 15th place at the top of the hill. And at that point, we were probably like 1,200 meters from the finish line, maybe a K from the finish line. Yeah, at the top of the hill, like for my race, Parker was at that point like really trying to hammer to close the gap on Kamari up front. So he was kind of executing his race plan really well at that point. But the whole pack at the same time was kind of covering Parker's move. So we were all hammering up the hill, kind of just following Parker as he moved up. And yeah, so I was just kind of in that pack. So my race plan going into this, because it was a big championship race, was to like really focus the last mile. Because to be honest, you can go run 2 miles, however you can run however far you want. All that really matters is who gets across like the line first. So for me, it was just to stay relaxed, stay just really relaxed, conserve energy the whole way, just let myself go. Just stay in the moment though, make sure I just focus on positioning myself where I needed to be, rather than just exerting my energy and doing extra work that I don't really need to do. So I was just kind of sitting in the pack, and I don't know, I was just waiting for the last mile to like really get going after it. And I kind of wanted to just like make sure I got up that hill, because from that point on, you can just, there's like maybe like one like baby hill, but at that point it's just getting to the finish line, which is like 1200 meters left. So it was easy to manage mentally. So my race plan is to get to the top of the hill and then hammer it down to the line. And at that point, it's all in for the, because last race of the year, my senior, like got it ended on a big note. And once at the top of the hill, all I could think about was like, this is it for me. So that was like where I decided like how I wanted to end my year. And at that point, I wasn't happy at all with like where I was in the race, and I really wanted to close and get where I wanted to be. So at that point, I surged really hard for like 10 seconds just to get like momentum back under me, and I just hammered back in towards the race. Or hammered, got myself back in the pack. Or Parker was just up front at this point, just hammering away the last K, I would say. And just said he just super strong. He's got a huge engine coming down from elevation. Kid's a monster. And he was just setting the pace for the rest of the field. And we were all just trying to cover it, and we were just rolling with it. And I was kind of deep in the pack. And then over like the last 800, 600 meters, I just kicked really early and just kind of dug down really deep the whole way and closed down. Kind of, I was able to move through the pack quite a bit and get all the way up into fourth place and ran 14:36 at the end. So that was really good. I kind of just executed what I wanted to do. And like my strength has always been like running a really strong, like last 1,000 meters or whatever. Like my kick has always been my strength. So I just really want to focus on that and make sure I use that to the best of my ability at this race, because this is where it all counted up. And I feel like I did a good job of that for the most part. But yeah, like those front three guys, Parker, Creed, and Nate, the whole like top 10 itself was so close and just really hammered the last mile. And I think that was like a big thing of the race, was just the last mile we really definitely like shifted down gears way faster than we were going during the second mile. And I think that was just a lot to say, like that it was a championship race. And I think for all of us, it was just our senior years on the line. So we wanted to like really just make it something that we were proud of. And that was definitely it for me. And I think I just did a good job of that. Parker definitely was just really strong, closed out the race. But yeah, I don't really know what else I'm missing. All right, so that kind of wraps up my little summary of the race. Hope that was a little bit helpful. I don't really know. But yeah, if you like the content, like and subscribe. And yeah, with that kind of wraps up the senior year cross country season. And I'll see you guys in the next video.